I'll tell you what, Grace, does anyone else hate ads on YouTube these days? I'm gonna get a proper music player sorted out soon, but my god, I hate these ads you can't skip. I do have ad block, by the way. Back shortly.
Team band.
Hi there, guys. Game two is now underway. We're going to get you back into the game right now as soon as I can figure how to use my software to make the transition. This is my first time in a while I've been casting again. So, once again, I want to give a big shout out to JoinDota for letting me cast their league and also to Erendir, who's been very helpful and very, well, basically, I'm very appreciative for allowing me to, do this, and he's been helping me out. So, but enough of the thanks. We're going to hop straight back in onto the game. So this is going to be Wheel versus Pain Gaming, game two of two. So this is it's not a best of three series. It's just a two-game league series. Wheel did actually take the first game away from Pain Gaming with a very interesting minus armor strats, but we'll run over the draft now. Wheel banning out the Faceless Void and the Chikiro. So once again, very big team fight operators. Make sure they want to get that shut down. And we do get Pain Gaming banning out the Venge and the Tides, so some respect bans coming out there as they did have their way of them last game. So we get a Brewmaster pickup for Pain Gaming count. Then we get the Naga and the Shadow Fiend pickup as well. So Naga can be quite good at just controlling that Brewmaster, and it's also really hard for the Brewmaster to gank anyone with that ulti. Brewmaster pops the ulti, Naga pops her ulti in retaliation. Most of the Brew split is pretty much wasted, and you'd much rather trade a Song for a Brewmaster split at the end of the day. So probably gonna be a little bit frustrated by that, unless they manage to even lock down the Naga before she can cast the Song, or they bait out the Song and then jump on her. But we do get the Shadow Fiend picked up again for Wheel. So these guys obviously appreciate this hero, very confident in it. Putting it as a second pick, I mean, Shadow Fiend isn't without his flaws. He has a terrible laning stage, really low base damage. But these guys are obviously very comfortable running him. Go, you know what? We want to show our hand right now. We are going to go with the Shadow Fiend again. He's going to get farmed. We're going to wreck your armor. We're going to try and carry this through the game. This could be a carry Naga. It's probably going to be a support, though. Just because, Shadow Fiend and a Naga, if they're both core, it's going to be a very greedy first pickup. Nature's Prophet then picked up for Pain Gaming, so a very mobile hero, really good at the split pushing, and probably a bit more notable, can be a bit more active at the early game. I mean, the Nature's Prophet can jump in on ganks and the Shadow Fiend. Shadow Fiend typically, of course, not a Quelling Blade buyer. TP in, trap him, he goes down in a couple of seconds with a concentrated burst, so. Scarf banned out, which I believe Pain. Nah. Pain had the Skyraff last game, so they just don't want to face it. Obviously, because of the Brew, Skyraff being obnoxious for the Brewmaster, having to force him to go into that BKB instead of the Korax items he normally wants to do. And Wheel banging out the Terror Blade as well. So, hero who can go ham against Shadow Fiend late game. If you get low, you can just Thunder, steal all his HP back. Doesn't really care about the minus armor as well because Terror Blade has a ridiculous amount of armor as he builds pure stats. The agility on the Skadi, on the Manta, on Butterfly, Easy to push 30 armor on that hero, so a paltry 6 armor from the orc isn't going to do much. Anti-mage as well, very similar thing. Really good against the susceptible. Really, normally, not very good. Sorry, normally very hard to try and take down an anti-mage with the magic resistance and the good armor. Necrophos banned out as well by Pain Gaming, so they don't want to give him this hero, which is just going to lock someone completely out of the fight. Really good team fighter as well. But we do actually pick up the Tusk, so quite interesting. I mean, you can do a few combos with this hero. It's a lot easier to control the snowball now. Who wants to go with it? I guess you could do a Tusk into a Naga Song or a Tusk into a Shadow Fiend, who then raises when they're right on top of him. Interesting hero. Gonna have to see exactly how this pans out, but remaining optimistic. Never quite know.
Reserve time.
So going off anything by this last game, I think Wheel are probably going to go for this
Tired.
really aggressive team once again. I mean, the Tusk is an aggressive hero by choice. Enchantress picked up by Pain Gaming now. So the Nature's Prophet's going to be going to a lane, not going to be a jungle prophet, though jungle prophet's quite rare these days. Might be an offlane, could even be a mid prophet. I mean, mid prophet does do quite well against the Shadow Fiends. You can harass him with the trees, you've got better right click, you've got better, I'd say, attack animation than the Shadow Fiends. So it could be a mid prophet, gets that early Dagon rush, makes that Shadow Fiend's life a living hell.
Seconds remaining.
Enchantress pick up there. I mean, this isn't a hero we see very much in the competitive scene these days. Just
Reserve
because
time.
Chen, Enchantress, these sort of heroes which pick creeps to come along with them, I don't think they generally work as well, especially with the nerf to the Centaur, or the Centaur Warrunner or Karn, or not Centaur Warrunner, the Karn, where you used to have the attack speed bonus and the stun, and now they swapped the attack speed bonus onto the Ursa, or the Hellbear. So I think it's sort of a nerf to how the creeps sort of work there, because you can't get the stun and the attack speed on one. But I think it's just because there's so many heroes these days which are really good at just mopping up these summons and just clearing them out. So an interesting pick. I mean, it's going to be a real pain in the ass for the Shadow Fiend to right click against her. I mean, you get the Witch Doctor, so someone who also greatly benefits from minus armor. And I completely forgot to notice that the Riptide also reduces armor, so these guys love their physical attacks and their minus armor. And the Death Ward being physical benefits greatly from minus armor as well. If anybody's played Witch Doctor knows, you play a Witch Doctor, you get that Death Ward, you place it down, you start channeling. If an enemy team's got high armor, you're like, why isn't it doing any damage? Likewise, if the enemy team's got no armor, you're like, oh
Ten
wow, I'm
seconds
complete.
remaining.
Wow, this is like killing them. I'm gonna have like 4 seconds left on my duration of my ulti afterwards, so
5 seconds remaining.
interesting. I'm liking it. It's a very unique draft. I'm just sort of wondering how Pain Gaming is going to
Reserve
answer, because they
time.
don't really have much. Pain Gaming don't have any stuns. They have a pseudo hold in place of the Sprout. They have a single target slow. But I mean, compared to the Net, the Snowball, the Shards, the Cask, it just seems that we all have a bit more better late game at the minute and better control.
Dire team ban.
Another defensive hero pickup. Can be quite good against the Shadow Fiend, because I believe if you disrupt the Shadow Fiend, his illusions do get the presence of the Dark Lord aura, so you get a bit of minus armor for yourself. And it can be quite good at stopping heroes.
10 seconds remaining.
Wow, that was loud. It can be quite good against heroes like the Witch Doctor,
5 seconds remaining.
who wants to get that channel off, because he's probably not going to get BKB anytime soon. And can be quite good defensively for
Reserve
snowball
time.
targets, so guess a good pick. I'm just not really seeing much punch coming out from Pain Gaming's lineup. It's going to be interesting, to say the least. I'm not entirely sure who is going to pull ahead from this. I mean, Pain Gaming looks like they might have it in the early stages of the game. The Enchantress comes out of a good creep, the Shadow Demon to the disruption to set it up, Nature's Prophet TPing in. Brewmaster's incredibly good in the early game, normally hits his peak around about that 11 mark. Rank 2 ulti, normally it's Blink Dagger and Vlad's, or if he's lucky, Blink Dagger and AC if he's got that much farm. But so far, Pain Gaming cannot go late against this Wheel lineup. The Brew will be very
Dire
ineffective late
team
game.
ban.
The Shadow Fiend will just right click his pandas down. And the Witch Doctor and the Tusk and the Naga are just really good for controlling and just making sure that the Nature's Prophet, Enchantress, and Shadow Demon aren't going to get anything done. So we see
10 seconds
Wheel
remaining.
banning out like four hard carries and a support. So they know that Pain
Five
needed this
seconds
big
remaining.
hard hitting carry now to get them through this. They're banning out all of the big ones which could have a massive immediate
Reserve time, ten
effect, the
seconds
Terrorblade ulti,
remaining.
the PA crit, getting rid of them. While Pain are happy banning out
Dire
just
team pick.
people who can mess with them in the mid game, Puck being a good example. The Silence, the Dream Coil, you do not want Pain Gaming to group up. Otherwise, the Shadow Fiend, the Naga, the Witch Doctor, the Tusk are all just going to throw their AoE abilities and just have a good old fun time. So, a good ban out by Pain. I don't really know how to ensure they're going to lane this. I mean, Shadow Fiend mid, it could be a farm. Probably Shadow Fiend mid, farm Naga bottom with Witch Doctor support. Could be a Tusk off lane, which leaves. It could be a support Naga, and this could be a carry. There could be a carry Tusk. It's a very bizarre situation. I'm not sure they're going to handle it, but Wheels last game revolved around sort of like four supports and one big core. No way. It's Meepo! We got a game. We got a game. We got a Meepo. I have never had the pleasure of casting a Meepo before in my small casting career. So this is a great honor to have the first Meepo pick in front of me. I'm quite excited, if I'm being honest. And we get an Ember Spirit out for Pain. So this Ember Spirit needs to get stuff done, and he needs to get stuff done fast. He needs a good start. He needs to win mid, get that good item. I don't think he can afford to go for this bot rush. I think he needs to get these. Well, I guess he could do if you want supply early pressure, but this Meepo is going to level up quick. He's going to get levels, but he's not going to get farm as quick. So this Ember's going to want to get some nice damage items, a couple of Battle Furies, maybe cleave off all the Meepos together. But yeah, we're going to go into the game. Bear me just 2 seconds. I'm waiting for my Steam thing to disappear, so then I've got a friend log on. Okay. So guys, this is game two of Pain Gaming versus Wheel. Sort of introduce the guys now. So we have Derped Up over there on the Witch Doctor. I'm a sheep, best name ever, because I'm Welsh, standing in on the Tusk there. Shadow Fiend being played by Relic. Slazel, I hope that's how you pronounce it, playing the Naga. It looks like it is going to be a farm Naga, going for the Statue of the Ring of Protection, probably could go for the Aquila and the Poor Man Shield. And that leaves Fanov Soyon, sorry, on the Meepo, which leaves VSW on the Enchantress. They're actually going to smoke gank into the enemy jungle aggressively, probably going to look to ward up the camp just to stop the Meepo. No, they're looking for kills. They might find one. This Witch Doctor is gonna he's gonna be out of position, but no, they managed to find the they managed to, oh, the Meepo. This could be a big pick if they can get it. They just can't get in range. Could be the clap from the Brewmaster. Clap comes out. He's gonna use a poof. Actually does a decent amount of damage, but that is gonna be the first blood given to the Enchantress. What an obnoxious laugh. But that's gonna be a nice little start to her. She's probably gonna be able to get maybe that Midas, get that nice gloves of attack early. She's actually going aggressive in the enemy jungle. Nope, she's just placing a ward. They see the Naga. This could be another kill, actually. They're gonna harass her a bit. She's like, oh god, where do I go? Do I go left or go up? She's gonna get away. 8 armor and a poor man shield. They're not gonna do. I mean, even despite these right clicks, she only lost 100 health, but a nice start so far. Oh, I like this Tusk set. That's nice. It is gonna be the Shadow Fiend mid against the Brewmaster. I'm gonna finish my introduction now because I got rudely cut off. So we've got Pesadelo playing on this Nature's Prophet, who looks like he's an offlane solo. King RD over on the Brewmaster. Bugger down mid on the Shadow Demon, which leaves 4DR on our Ember Spirit, who's actually gone bottom lane against the Tusk, so should be a nice easy lane for the Ember Spirit to win, especially since all of Tusk's damage at the start comes from magic. Ember Spirit's probably going to go for that heavy build into Flame Guard. 2 mid. They really want the Shadow Fiend to be able to get a few last hits, just get those few stacks up on Necromancy to make it easier to lane against this Brew. The castle's going to bounce a couple of times. This Brew is getting harassed a lot. He has got the point in Drunken Brawler, but he's getting completely zoned out by this Witch Doctor. Was that an enchant on the Sentinel? This is what I mean. The Sentinel only has the clap now, or the war stomp, and it just sort of feels lackluster without it now. I mean, the sun's all well and good, but it's so hard to set up without something like an iron shell, not an iron shell, a surge to speed it up or something. So, ah well, maybe he was too powerful before. Now he's balanced. Now I'm not sure. They're gonna go the Panda in mid again. He does have the evasion. They're gonna pop on the heal. Not quite enough damage to get up, but there is a raise. Could he even that? Nah, not with 100 health left. Nah, so if I'm nowhere near, if you hit him with both raises, that would have been enough, but yeah, the chance that he could have, but you might have just been out of range for the mid range. He was definitely in range for the long range, though. Brewmaster's not going to have a good time. He might have to put an early point into the Drunken Haste just to blind the Shadow Fiend, stop him getting. In fact, I'm surprised they didn't give you that earlier. Put a point in the Drunken Haste quite early, and that means the Shadow Fiend can't actually get any last hits at all, but he did go for the clap for the first blood, which was worth it, so. And one thing you got to keep in mind is that this is sort of halting the Enchantress' progression because you can't jungle if the Sentinel's just hanging out in mid. The Sentinel's only been used to go and harass mid. It's going to run out now. They take control of a Darkthrall Summoner though, which equally a good mob. But I don't see her getting a kill off this. I think she's probably worthwhile farming up. So yeah, Shadowfiend leading the way in the last hits right now. Ember Spirit bottom beating the Tusk, which, as predicted, it should be quite a nice lane for this Ember Spirit as long as it doesn't get rotated on. And the Nature's Prophet, while a ranged hero, just the Naga is such an annoying hero to deal with. I mean, 9 armor, stout shield, should probably upgrade that to a poor man's shield anytime now. No, not going to go for the poor man's. Thought she would have because then that guaranteed attack block, but Nature's Prophet doing alright. He's not getting that much farm necessarily, only on 6 last hits, but I think he's just quite happy getting the levels. Gets to level 5, he can go to another lane, take his trees with him, try and push a tower. Tusk is getting slightly zoned out down bottom. They want to give this Ember complete free farm, so they've invested this safe lane for him. The only problem I foresee is that these camps are being stacked. Okay, they are being stacked. Okay, I was worrying with the Witch Doctor mid that the Shadowfiend was going to fall behind in levels, but Shadowfiend's probably going to hit level 5, go to the jungle, couple of raises, probably hit level 6, maybe nearly level 7 just off a double camp stack. The Witch Doctor doing a very good job with that. Oh, here comes Hellbear Smasher. Look at that face. He's not happy. I think he's looking for the Witch Doctor. Can he see him? I think he can. Yeah, he can see him. He's like, no, stop it, Witch Doctor. Leave him alone. They're my friends. Oh my god, the clap. Is Witch Doctor going to get soloed by an Ursa? No way. The attack speed is really better for the Witch Doctor's getting soloed by an Ursa. Nature's Prophet comes in as well. He's like, yeah, well, screw it. The Ursa wants to keep going, I'm going to. Oh, this could be bad. Oh no, Nature's Prophet. Oh, the bounces and the raise. Nature's Prophet, a little bit greedy then. A good idea. Bit of miscommunication. The Enchantress's Hellbear had started to back out while the Nature's Prophet still wanted to go in. So, bit of miscommunication. I mean, it does free up the Brewmaster for a minute. Or about 30 seconds. He gets a little bit of farm now. So, you know, small victories along with small losses. This is the time though where the Shadow Fiend is going to start getting really deadly. I mean, he's already got 100 right click damage at least. It's just over now. We're looking at 101. The Brute does have 2 points of the Drunken Brawler, so I mean, he's going to be happy in the fact he's going to dodge every 6 hit, one in every 6 hits, one guaranteed as well. And this is going to be a farm in Naga, so we'll go. This time we're going for the incredibly greedy lineup where Pain seems to be going for this more. We want to sort of take fights early build. Enchantress hasn't bought anything yet. It could be. I don't think this would be a straight set to rush. Oh no, the Brewmaster gets caught out. He's going to get disrupted. The save comes out. And Nature's Prophet comes in as well. But the Raze does manage to finish him off. The Shadow Fiend does drop and return. Bit of a shame the Enchantress couldn't get there that little bit sooner and pop off the Enchant. But I think the Raze would have had him anyway. Not the Enchant, the Nature's Attendants. Not the greatest trade, especially considering that your Pain's mid were down first and they had to commit 4 heroes to get that kill. I mean, we only talked about this Meepo. I mean, the Meepo's level 4. He's not got the levels you'd expect out of a Meepo. But then again, he's just been jungling. I think he's in the lane for a very short period of time, and then he just gave it over to the Naga. Ember Spirit does actually manage to get a kill on the Tusk down bottom. He wants that Sigil gold. Give me that Sigil gold. Ah, the creeps get it. That is a rich creep. He's going to go back and upgrade his pointy stick to a 2 pointy sticks or a pointy fireball stick. It's been an interesting sight into our game so far. I mean, the net worth, you can't even cast that off. That's a ward. That's a ward with a net worth right there. The experience, okay, that's probably about hero kill. So, very even so far. But if it's even, you've got to sort of favour Wheel. I mean, Pain with Shadow Demon and Enchantress, they're obviously the better early game supports. And Wheel are playing this very greedy. They want a Tusk to farm at bottom or get levels. They want the Shadow Fiend to farm. They want Naga to farm. They want Meepo to farm. They want Witch Doctor to just annoy people. Stack is discovered. They might be able to get on the Meepo. They're coming in from all sides. Oh no, the cask is bouncing back and forth. Enchantress just gets completely popped and blown up. The spit does get interrupted by. He does going to pop off. He does get interrupted by the net. They're going to try and chase down. They're going to go for this Meepo. Oh, it's the Witch Doctor. Right, Blue Mask is going for the Meepo. Shalium's going for the Witch Doctor. They're splitting their targets. Are they even going to get any kills out of this? They are going to get the Meepo. Ugh. They lose the Enchantress and the Shadow Demon in exchange for the Meepo, and they force out the Brewsprit as well. So I'd say that is quite a victory for Wheel, considering that Naga Siren's just been free farming top all the while. Nature Prophet does even up with a kill on Tusk bottom, so okay, that does even it out. I mean, it shows it sort of goes that way. Oh, this is just for the Tusk fight, so obviously Tusk dies, he loses gold, they own gold. Experience, yay. Can't remember to use that fight recap more. Nature's Prophet is going to do the smart thing, send a tree ahead just to pull the wave. Naga does get the top tower as well. Shadow Demon's only level 4 as well.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Even towers now. This Ember Spirit, he's got to go for this big item. Okay, he's not gone for the bots. He has gone for the phase, which is good. Which means he's probably going to go for that Battle Fury rush. Maybe drums first. He's just going to wait. Has he got a remnant? He can jump back to his remnant down bottom. Nifty little trick you can do. Brewmaster is mid-meal. They see him. They've got the vision there. They know there's a sentry. They've just seen him walk past. They're like, Shadow Fiend's coming for you. The Shadow Fiend is actually still sticking around, but the Brew just can't get in range. They know, though. The Brew just got attacked by the wolf. They know there's some sort of vision. He's still going. He doesn't have a blink. He should just concentrate on farming right now. He's only about 600 gold away from his blink. Meepo, in the meanwhile, just. I don't really know what they're going to do with this hero. It's going to be interesting, to say the least, but. Here comes the snowball. Mass snowball coming in. Are they going to go on the Enchantress? Oh, it's right into the Brewmaster. He doesn't have split. What was he doing? I don't. Oh, they're going to pop. Shadow Demon is not going to finish him off. That Witch Doctor ulti, fantastic. I don't really know what the Brewmaster was doing there. He didn't have the split. He didn't have much mana. He just got completely exploded. I mean, Pain obviously not ready to take that fight. Is not the Ember Spirit had no intention of coming in. The Enchantress was late. Nature's Prophet didn't want to. Oh, Nature's Prophet TP was on cooldown, so bit of an awkward fight. They could have just lost the Shadow Demon for that, but they decided to lose more. So
Dire's bottom tower is
bit
under
confused.
attack.
But I mean, give it to Wheel. I mean, I've never personally seen this team before, but I mean, they come off really strong, and they're going for this incredibly greedy lineup, and Pain just aren't punishing them for it. I mean, this Naga. I thought she was going to go for the Radiant. She does finish off the Aquila, Bottle, and Boots. Probably going to go for the Radiance now. Meepo's just AFK getting experience. And this is just going really well by way of Pain. Well, by way of Wheel. I mean, you've got to, if you're dead even, you've got to favor Wheel going into the sort of the late game. The mid game could be anybody's game. The Panda Split is still very powerful at that stage of the game. But if it stays even and they don't manage to capitalize on the mid game, I just don't see Pain being able to deal with what Wheel can offer late game. So, a little bit worried at the minute. I mean, the next 10 minutes are really going to show what the pace of the game is going to take. You know, the Witch Doctor is level 6 now. I think Shadow Demon is still 4. Now he's 5 now, so he's getting some levels. I just don't really see what the Shadow Fiend's offering the team, though. I mean, it's really good on the disruption on the Brewmaster. Make sure you don't get shut down before you can get the split off, but. Oh, it was Ogre banned? I think he was banned. Otherwise, I'm not sure why one of these teams wouldn't have picked him. They're going to throw out the shards. The heal comes out. It's like, I want all the healing for myself. You ain't having any, Brewmaster. Are they going to go on him? That is a lot of damage coming out of that impetus then. Oh. I think he was gonna think about Nayan, the short range raise. Oh, here comes the punch. Are they gonna burst him dead in time? Oh, he's actually gonna turn around and just go on him. Nature's Prophet will be coming out as well, provides the necessary burst to bring him down. And Tusk thought, oh, I've got this, I've got my friend Witch Doctor here with me. And Witch was like, no, you're by yourself, mate, I'm not coming in there. But yeah, nice little turnaround there. So, Ember Spirit, obviously knowing the extent of his hero, realizes that once the punch comes out, Tusk has nothing more he can do to me if he's by himself. Nature's Prophet, oh, he comes out, good coordination, they get the kill. So, he is going to go for the Battle Fury. He does pick up the Perseverance now. Normally, you see. Normally, a lot of heroes who build Battle Fury, they normally tend to go for the Ring of Health, and then they'll go for the two swords before they go back for the mana. But, Perseverance, very important on Ember Spirit. Needs that mana regen as he throws out mana like there's no tomorrow. Still kind of scared. This Naga is only 800 gold away from a relic. And she got bounty rooms, so we could pretty much say that's an extra 50 to 100 gold depending on when she pops it. She's probably gonna wait for level 10. Because, of course, I think the higher you are when you pop it, the more you get out of it. Optimizing every little penny and every little bit of experience counts after all. I miss my co-caster, Raikou. I don't have anybody to interrupt me. I feel kind of weird just endlessly talking non-stop. I think everyone likes co-casters more as well. Oh wait, never mind. Going on top, the clack comes out. Naga does not have enough of the song. She's completely out of mana, and I think they waited for that very moment. They're diving, but they're not getting much done. They're gonna keep going, but she's just balling up. And can they kill her? The brew split's gonna end. Oh, the nature's prophet already comes in. That massive nuka damage is just enough. The brewmaster actually reforms. Oh no, Meepo and Tusk and Shadow Fiend and Witch Doctor. I mean, that is good for pain. At the end of the day, you do delay the Radiance timing on the Naga, and that's the Naga is definitely the scariest thing looking forward on Wheels Gaming. Emisper does get the last hit on the tower. Little bit of gold swinging their way. Is it gonna be a Roche? They have got it warded. With Enchantress plus the Nature's Prophet, they could do a Roche, but it would be a slow one. And with the Naga, especially against the Naga, it's very dodgy to do that sort of Roshan when the song can come in. Three dire heroes, wheel pushing top. Blue Master blinks in aggressively. This could be a very bad idea. He just blinks in and Death Ward comes out. He's going to get stunned and he has just popped. I don't know why he did that. Like, he didn't have split. He must have known he didn't have split. He only popped it recently. And you could see that there was two heroes pushing there. You could definitely see the two. I don't think you've seen the Witch Doctor. Or the Tusk, sorry, but yeah, very suspicious. Yeah. Ember Spirit playing a bit cocky here, you know, showing his forefront. He does have a remnant to jump to, just a little bit further back. There we go. And if you jump to the remnant, he's nice and safe. Tusk plus three Meepos. Hell of a party in that snowball. Meepo has a Blink Dagger now. So he has got the ability to jump in and kill Nature's Prophet, Enchantress, Shadow Demon, Ember, if he's caught without the shield or the remnants. He could probably even kill the Panda before the split comes off. The Panda doesn't really have that much. That death just. I mean, he's 2-4-2. I mean, this is not what we want to be with your Panda. 15 minutes, he's just got the naked Blink Dagger with a wand and a bottle. You're sort of hoping that by this point you've got your upgraded boots for a start. You certainly have got your upgraded boots, and you've either got your Hyperstone or a plate mail or your Vlads. You've just got something else by this point, so that when you split, you've got that extra bit of oomph to it. But it just doesn't have it. And 15 minutes, naked Blink Dagger. This brew isn't having a good game so far. He's actually getting out farmed by the jungling Meepo. And I know Meepo has the ability to farm really quickly, but he did get zoned out in mid, I guess. But his brew isn't even level 11, and that is a really tricky thing. He still doesn't have that level 2 split. The duration, just 15 seconds. I know it's only 2 seconds for each rank, but you can really feel the difference playing brew but from 15 seconds all the way to 19 or 17 seconds. So that could be the extra boulder, the extra toss in the air, the extra dispel. You know, you could have numerous extra things in that extra 2 second time. Plus the extra 2 seconds pseudo invulnerability from getting ganked. Shadow Fiend's like, go away, Enchantress. No more creeps for you. Thank you for giving me free jungle farm. Oh, this is going to be a big jump. The Sprint comes out. They do manage to jump out on two. The Shadow Fiend actually throws out just a defensive ulti. Oh, no. They do manage to get the pop onto the Shadow Fiend. The Ember Spirit dies shortly afterwards as well. But this Witch Doctor, nobody's stopping him. The Brood Split finally is enough. But the Witch Doctor's healing up. They don't have enough right click about this Ember Spirit. Oh, did they get it? They do manage to get a kill on the Witch Doctor, but this Meepo is going to clean house now. Gone. Ultra kill for the Meepo. So, a complete wipeout for the Pain side there, losing only 2 in return. 2000 gold shift isn't that much at this stage in the game. I mean, by all things considered, it's not really that big of a swing either way. But I mean, if you look in terms of the abilities that was used and how the fight panned out, it looks like it was Pain's fight. They got the Shadow Fiend down really low at the start. They do manage to get him, but it cost them a lot. And it's just like I said, it's just the power of this Meepo. He just jumps in, and he poops. The hero's already gone. Enchantress, I didn't even see her in that fight. I think she just got completely exploded. The Ember Spirit got focused as well. And that Witch Doctor, that ulti was really good. I mean, he got that off for nearly the entire duration. I think at the last second it was cancelled. This Meepo could drop and just drop to the Ancients. Oh, so close. They can see this. Is someone going to come in? Oh, Nature's Prophet. Nature's Prophet's here. He wants his kill. He wants his kill. He's too slow. Oh, hesitation. This Nature's Prophet's like, oh, God, I gotta get out, gotta get out, gotta get out. And he's gone. Oh, Nature's Prophet Blink Ball just a second more. Or, no, an extra, like, attack or attack further ahead. He probably would have got that. But yeah, just going back to that fight, that Witch Doctor just fantastic ult. You're on the high ground. Couldn't see him until, they had to literally specify the brew to go on him. He didn't think he took all his brewlings to take him on as well, so you don't really want to focus all your attention on the slot 5 Witch Doctor. And I see a bunch of watery ladies running around with glowing sun effect. So that is the radiance up on the Naga now. So if life was hard before, it's only going to get harder now. You're against the clock. I mean, the good news is the Ember Spirit is fantastic at cleaning up the illusions. Like, these illusions won't do nothing to him, but he can't be everywhere at once. No, like, this Naga, when she gets bots and Mantis, she's gonna have this like sort of omnipresence. And there we go. Look, we're just gonna see this now. Sunbeam's like, I'm dead. I'm gonna pop a wand just because I like my wand, and I'm gonna get netted, and I'm gonna die. Really not fun playing against a Naga when you're like a poor support. Brewmaster jumps in aggressively. He does have the split. He's gonna throw it out actually. Got to focus on one Meepo particularly. He's gonna focus on the back one here. There should be a Meepo death. Yeah, Neepo's gone. Oh no. Okay, really nicely done. Interruption. They purge it off. This is the rock. Okay, the Brewmaster really well done then. So I literally thought he jumped away then. I was really worried. Like, oh no, he threw out the ulti. Shadowbane on Nature's Prophet. Interesting. This is a real old school build. The No, I think normally see the Treads Midas Shadow Blade. Phase, I mean, phases are of course really good for the lane domination and just it's better, sort of right clicking damage for team fights, but he's very squishy about the Treads, doesn't have the extra strength. 6 armor, 800 health. Shadow Blade adds virtually nothing to your survivability. All it's gonna take is his Witch Doctor to get a gem. The Naga's already gonna provide loads of map control. I'd actually be very surprised if the Witch Doctor doesn't invest in a gem very soon. Because he knows he's never going to have a problem with warding, because Snaga's going to have this map constantly under wraps. But yeah, I mean, I think that Pain were the favourites going into this matchup. I'm very impressed by Wheel. I mean, like I said, I've never seen this team before, but they're just executing so well at the minute, and they're focusing the right people, and they know what to do out of their lanes, and there's been some fantastic rotations. That's probably the weirdest looking punch I ever saw. They're gonna get mid. Oh no, Brewmaster. I think he jumped in or they jumped on him, but he's gone. Oh, that Ice Shard. It completely traps off the Enchantress. The Disruption comes out just to delay a little bit, but it's only a matter of time. Enchantress is gonna drop, and Shadow Fiend's probably just behind him. Shadow Fiend's gone. This is sort of, we go back to the start of the draft. It's, you've got all these, really good sort of support at the start who can roam, who are defensive, who can try and get some ganks in the lane. But I mean, what is the Enchantress and the Shadow Demon actually offering you now? They're not doing any damage at all in these fights because they either die really quickly or they're not damaging heroes in themselves. I mean, the Shadow Fiend already has a BKB, a mech, and he's already on the well on his way to his next time. He's probably going to see the butterfly once again, like in the last game. And the Ember Spirit just does not have the farm to contest this. He's going for that second Battle Fury, but as you can see, it just isn't enough yet. That first Meepo was dropping kind of low, to be fair. But, oh, can they stop him? Okay, that's a very nice disruption. This should be a dead Meepo. He's gone. Ember Spirit might be able to pick up a few extra stragglers. The Witch Doctor's moving very slow. Is he going to go the right way? Witch Doctor goes south. Ember Spirit goes north. Gank avoided. Radiant have a lot of wards in the Dire Jungle, which is quite. I think they did that to make sure the Ember could push top without any fear, but. It's sort of like they're watching the Naga farm. It's like, yeah, we can see this Naga farming. That's fantastic. It's going to be really tricky for us later. Kilda's going on the bottom. The Nature's Prophet does die. And the Shadow, it's just going to get a bit silly soon because the Naga's getting farm. The Tusk's got a Blink Dagger. The Shadow Fiend's getting farm. And you have an Ember Spirit. And he's trying his hardest, the poor guy. He's got two Battle Furies, but. Song comes out. Naga's like, I don't want it on this fight. If it wasn't for the double damage, she probably would have just went against him. He's not going to split. No. I think he debated it then. He debated the split, but he thought, I'm not going to be able to get the split with the cast time and the animation, and then get the stun off. And even then, the stun is arranged. It travels really slowly. It's like slower than an auto attack. Wise idea by the panda there. If he did actually bring out the split, it would have been a great waste. And we all probably would have been like, oh, we should get a couple of towers. And they fear of retaliation now. So, nicely done. We are going in for the Roshan now. With the Meepos, it shouldn't be that hard to do. They can tank most of it, just pull out the Meepo that gets slow. Punch comes out, and the Sigil as well, really going to slow Roshan's attack speed. I think, yeah, 1.2, maybe not greatly, but it's 30, yeah, it's 30 slow. It's pretty damn nice. It's two Gloves of Haste. Incoming. Oh, that Ember Spirit, that Cleave just absolutely decimates them. The Panda can't split. The Panda can't split. Oh, no. Oh, he does split at the last second. The Panda does get the split off. Down goes the Meepo, down goes the Tusk. This could actually be the team fight they wanted. Naga is actually coming on the back end. They're going to try and go the Shadow Fiend. They do have enough to bring him down. He actually pops. And they're going to go on the Witch Doctor as well. So, a fantastic little turnaround then. This Ember Spirit actually doing a lot of work. Naga's just going to TP out. They can't stop her, but they will be able to stop the Witch Doctor. So, a 4-for-1 trade. And bring me up that fight recap. I want to see that. Whew. 1,000 gold lost on the Dire side. Naga looks like does manage to get a pick up on the Enchantress, get a little bit of brick gold there. But the Radiant side, nice amount of gold, especially the Ember Spirit and the 7,000 experience. I mean, that is a very nice amount. 2,500 to the Ember. Let's look at those hero levels. 17, yeah, he's going to have a lot. He's probably going to be going towards a crit stick. I'd be very surprised if he doesn't have one. Lincoln's? Scardy? I don't know. We'll have to wait and see what that is. Sheep stick? I don't know. Could be anything. But overall, very good fight. I mean, gold was starting to go the other way quite badly, but they did recover like half of that lead then, from about 7,500 back to about 3,000, 4,000. Never mind about that, they're going to go on the Tusk. Tusk turns to a snowball and he's just going to run away. Oh no, Nature's Prophet actually finishes him off with the Nature's Wrath. Ember Spirit jumps away. And I guess the one good thing is that they didn't really have that, I was about to say, they didn't really have that much lockdown for December, but oh my god, they're just going to go in and kill him. The Reaper's like, hey guys, I can slow him down, I can slow him down. And Ember's like, I don't care, I'm just going to cleave you down. This Ember's getting notoriously dangerous now. Pain might actually be able to, you know, this Ember Spirit of not that much strength might just be able to carry his entire team on his back, you know? It's going to. The gold's definitely tipping up. Over half the advantage now lost. Oh, look at that. Look, about a solid 6,000 gold. Probably just swung right away there. Experience about 9,000. I mean, that is a huge swing, and that's all gone straight into this fat little Ember Spirit here. I mean, 4DR and this Ember Spirit definitely doing work. I mean, that cleave and the amount of damage that did, I would have thought that was a crit on that, but it was just a double Battle Fury, just really cleaving through them quickly. Enchantress is slowly working her way towards the Aghanim Scepter, halfway there. Down Nature's Prophet, Shadow Blades, Shadow Demon. He's actually nearly got four staff, so he's in that fight obviously worked out quite well for him because he actually survived that one. Got a decent amount of experience. Got a level 11, which is really good for a Shadow Fiend at this point. And the Ember just mopping, you know, bopping up. Going to get this massive stack of three ancient stacks here. Nice amount of gold. You know, it makes it really strange. I didn't even know you could Sleight of Fist these. How bad is that? He's never thought to do it before. Well, he's one of the best ancient clearers in the game. Witch Doctor. Oh, it's going to be a kill. They actually managed to get a kill on the Shadow Demon. The split comes out from the Brewmaster, but where's his team? I don't think they're anywhere nearby. He's just gone in by himself. This Ember Spirit is trying to try and make things work, but the Death Ward comes out. Ember Spirit's got to realize he realizes he's stayed in there too long. He's got to get out, minimize his losses. They're actually chasing him, though. Is he going to turn around? Yep, he's going to turn around, get that kill on the Brute, on the Tusk. Nature's Prophet's trying to get the Naga at the back line, can't manage to find him. And they're like, oh no, we've lost a few people. We've got to get out. Naga's TP'd out, we've lost a lot of support. Oh, the premeditated ulti They don't follow up the hill because the creeps are blocking them. Chalopine wants that last hit. They're actually going to pursue. They know where they are. They're going south. They know where that Chalopine is. I think we have to get, they do get the... That Shadowfiend's going to go down. There's nowhere for him to go. He's lost his TP scroll now. Demonic Purge comes out. Shadowfiend drops. The Witch Doctor is getting away. The cask bounces. This Witch Doctor could be the only person apart from the Naga who doesn't die. Nature Prophet's like, nope, you ain't going nowhere. I mean, I thought that was pretty hideous at first. Oh, Naga meanwhile gets a kill on Enchantress in the jungle. Okay. I thought that was going to go quite bad. The Brewmaster jumps in without his team, does the split. Everyone's like, solo blue, brew, yeah, we can kill the Pandalings. Nature's Prophet comes in, not that big a deal. And then the Ember Spirit comes in, just sows chaos. And this Meepo is really suffering. I mean, he's doing the nice gimmick of blinking in, getting the multiple poofs and killing these supports like the Shadow Demon here, but you can't afford to scoop your Meepos up against his Ember Spirit because it'll just be cleave, 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 cleave. Every time he does this Sleight of Fist, the Meepos are losing over half their health. And because there's so many Meepos, he's doing a lot of jumps, which means he's in his immunity for a lot longer. So by the time he comes out, his Sleight of Fist is already off cooldown again. He can just do it again. I think the Ember Spirit pick was a fantastic pick up here. The hero's doing very well for them. He might be able to sort of pick off this Tusk, actually, or the Shadow Fiend's there as well. He nets both of them, but he's not going to go, and he's like, ooh, Shadow Fiend's there, I'm not going to pursue into that. No way. Net worth dead even now. Experience actually going back in the way of pain, but it seems really weird this is only a 28-minute game because it feels like this is like 40 to 45 minutes with just because of how explosive the damage is coming out on this Ember Spirit. He feels like he's got a Daedalus. He feels like he's got a Desolator. He's not. It's just that these heroes on Wheel are just real late-game heroes who don't have these late-game items yet. I mean, okay, Naga's definitely getting there. In fact, she's about 1,000 or so gold off her heart, maybe just under. Obviously, why he goes for the Lincolns. Stop things like that net. Meepo meanwhile does get a kill on Nature's Prophet up top. That was a buyback death, so obviously down for a long period of time. Nature's Prophet out for it for a while. He's not really offering overly too much these fights. Brewmaster just jumping on the Meepo. He's going to poof, 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 poof. The Meepos all jump out. One is left remaining. They might be able to, yep, to stop this guy. Can't get the Shadow Poison. Nah, he's got out. So yeah, just no way to shut him down once the disruption's out. Nicely done by the Meepo there. He gets all of that apart from the largest HP one. Then the largest HP one just manages to poof away to safety. So nicely done. And I mean, just the Dire just want to have complete control of this map. They want this Naga to get loads of farm. They've got the Roshan pit watered up. They've got the mid lane. Radiant don't actually have, well, pretty much the same. The wards are in, you know, two wards, pretty much identical places. Top mid, then mid bot. Your sort of typical pub wards, maybe not so ones in the mid, but definitely the ones up here on the high cliff here. They're going to split. The Naga song does come out. The border comes out as well. They're going to be able to hold her until the song ends. Ember Spirit's nearby as well, so he's going to come in. This is going to be a dead Naga. There's nothing she can do about this. Oh, wait. She's running. She's running. The net comes out, and this is going to be chop, chop, chop. Brewmaster gets a nice little bounty there. 551 gold going directly into his pockets. He's got the AT now and the Vlad. So 15 minutes in, if you remember, I was saying he's only got a naked Blink Dagger and boots. In 15 minutes, he's farmed an AC and a Vlad. All of a sudden, this Panda's going to be a lot harder to take down. The Shadow Fiend Dora just isn't going to be enough anymore. And where has the Shadow Fiend been for like the last 3 minutes? He's just been farming, I think. Probably going for this. It's like a Skadi pickup, possibly. Death Ward comes out. It looks like he's going on to the Enchantress. She does drop. Nature's Prophet. This Witch Doctor's always just cleaving everyone up. Finally, they're like, screw it. We just need to get rid of him. Witch Doctor is over. It's already been 3 lost for Wheel, though. When December Spirit is just doing work. He's chopping him up. And the Shadow Fiend's like, oh god, I'm all alone. He's got the brew on him as well, so he can't right click, and that's an ultra kill. I didn't even realise the Ember Spirit was doing work then. I was like, the Witch Doctor, he's doing a load of work, and it's like, oh wow, Ember Spirit is suddenly just killing people. But the nature of this hero, he doesn't do damage like over time. He just massive load of burst, 6 seconds later, massive load of burst, 6 seconds later. You know, as daft as it sounds, I mean, we all had this early game set. You know, they would have really well with it, and They had this amazing farm going, the Naga had a decent Radiance timing. But now it looks like we'll maybe even try and find it a little bit hard to defend. That's exactly what's worried about. These illusions. I mean, is that a heart? That is a heart Naga. And this Ember Spirit is nearly one-shotting them. When he actually finishes off that Daedalus, that nice little boost up from the Demon Edge in terms of damage, it's just going to make it where he can one-shot the illusions. Oh no, they're going to go on the Ember Spirit. Does he have a Remnant to jump out to? He does. He's going to have to be quick though. He's gone. He's like, bye guys, I'm sticking around. Really well done. Premeditates a Meepo Blink and immediately jumps over to the right. And he's just gone. The Dire can see this, but there's nothing they can really do to stop him. The Naga Song is down, they don't have that assured way to initiate, and unless you bring three heroes, this guy's just going to kill you anyway. You can't really disregard the late game Naga though. Because as well as Ember Spirit does, if he gets caught out once in a net and he's out of surge charges, he's just going to be gone. He'll do his jump, and if he doesn't kill them all then, they're going to kill him in the 6 seconds before it, or the couple of seconds before it comes back up. He's just that squishy. I mean, 13 armor and 2k health isn't the tankiest, especially against the heroes like a Shadow Fiend or a Tusk who can just try and burst him down. I guess that's what the Pain Team is for, the Shadow Fiend to disrupt him, the Brewmaster make space for him. You know, Nature's Prophet, or, you know, Nature's Prophet, I've said he's not really been doing that much this match. In fact, very little, I'd say, sort of direct fighting, but that ulti has just been shredding Wheel up. Like, it's been bouncing around doing an incredible amount of damage. Shadow Demon gets his four staff, the supports are no longer poor. It's nice when you see supports actually pick up a core item, and when I say core item, something which is worth more than 1,000 gold. Four staff being the cheapest of the major support items, but then again, an essential one. The fastest hero moves 462, which is just pretty much just 60 under the move speed cap. Get a Yuls, probably be near enough there. Yuls Naga. Shadow Fiend does actually go for the Cipher Vice. So, a really good pickup against the Ember Spirit, because if you do catch him when he's outside of his jumping phase and he doesn't have Lincolns, he's down. 3.5 seconds, is it? 3.5 seconds, that's more than enough to burst down an Ember Spirit. So, a wise pickup. I do think. No, he's probably the best hero for. I mean, Meepo's got it as well. So, Meepo's also got a scythe. They're like, this Ember Spirit is completely killing us in fights. We need to shut him down. December Spirit, though, if he's smart, I think he's going to save for the buyback next. He's got to realize how instrumental he is to his team's victory. If he goes down, the fight just ends. There's like nothing the rest of his team can do to follow it up. They really hate this illusion. Look how long it takes these guys to kill it. Evade. Is that a butterfly on Naga? No, it's just a Talisman of Evasion. There we go. Shadow Demon, Killsteel. My illusion. Nature's Prophet doing what he does best and doing that good old-fashioned split pushing. TI3. Never forget. The Naga's playing quite a strange. She's been very aggressive with the Naga herself. Like, without the rest of her team just diving into the enemy jungle, like right near their tier 2, where reactions could come in. Normally, just see the Naga maybe come to about here, something along here. Split the illusions up, they go down there. She goes up here to farm with maybe one of the illusions or something, but then again, it's not really needed, so. She's been caught out a couple of times now because she's been over the side of the map. She's been in enemy borders or enemy territory, as it will. Myth of Roshan kill. Ember Spirit does pick another Aegis, so even if they do manage to use all these multiple scythes on him, they're going to have to try and do something when he comes back. So this just literally got twice as hard. This area's just doubled in worth now. And that Daedalus now. The only problem is that Ember Spirit is hitting his peak quite quickly. I mean, Lincoln's isn't the best late game item. I mean, I would have thought you. The problem is, I mean, Lincoln's offers a very limited amount of protection. It's good against Blink Initiators like a Blink Scythe. But, I mean, a BKB is good for a prolonged team fight if you can preempt. So, I don't know. I mean, late game, it could be worth trading out the Lincolns for a BKB or maybe even a Rapier or something. Shadow Fiend BKB popped out, so that is down to 7 seconds now, so small victory in itself. Then he's not going to have that BKB up, so if he gets caught by those searing chains again, he's going to go down. I just realised how much split push we'll actually have. I mean, they got the Naga and they got the Meepo. Imagine if they had the Nature's Prophet, it would have been insane. Yay! Enchantress now has a like the most powerful creep in the game for about a second. And just it gets it away if it's gone. Meepo is like camped in these trees. Poof, 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 they're all gone. Brewmaster's like, I heard something. Nope, no. Maybe in here? Nope. Yep, no, okay. Maybe in here? Yeah, no, yeah, no. Oh. That's a creep. I'll have you. Bang. You what, mate? I haven't really paid too much attention to Shadowfiend, but he hasn't really. I mean, he's got like 10 kills. He's obviously been in this fight. He's like, where are they? Damn it, it's Mud Golems! Go away! This irritating thing if you're like a spell based jungler. I mean, they're amazing if you're Axe or something, you know, because they do bugger all damage. They have any special abilities. They don't do like crits. They don't do fast attack speed. They don't have claps or anything like that if you've got illusions. Just by far the best creeps in the jungle if you're Axe. Or maybe the small satyr camp, the medium satyr camp could be good. This nature's prophet is like half health just from the Naga Radiance. He's like, guys, I've got to rethink this ult. Are they going to use the ulti? They're going to bring up a few people. Is the song going to come out? No, nature's prophet is like, ah, screw you, Ember. I'm going to go mid. Bot. Jungle? Jungle. Has got the scythe now, so his farm's starting to pick up. Gloves of Haste. Probably a Maelstrom, just to be able to push out and be really good against his Naga Illusions. Bottom looks like a big fight's going to kick off. They might go on the Brute. Disruption comes out. He's probably going to use the split straight away. He gets it. Hi, I'm Brew. I'm going to split now. They might be able to get the kill on that Meepo. He's going to drop. He's solo. He's gone. That's well worth it. And I mean, where's the Ember? The Ember is in. Does throw out the Sleight of Fist. He's going to find other people on the retreat. Naga's to the left. Everyone else ults up to the above. I mean, Brewmaster already was forced out, but I mean, the fact that Wheel jumped in and initiated on that Brewmaster, they lose one, and they don't kill the Brewmaster. I think that's a small victory for Pain there. Brewmaster ulti's down, but was there any BKBs used in that fight? No. No. You wish you had a BKB. Not that I'll do anything about this Ember Spirit at this stage, you just run up to him one shot, you know. And as we discovered near the Ancients, I knew it was physical damage all along. I just didn't think that you could use it on Ancients, but Witch Doctor is very susceptible to getting Sleight of Fisted. Do I build Ghost Scepter and not get Sleight of Fisted, or do I build BKB and get Sleight of Fisted? You're screwed either way. Quite nice to pop the Lincolns. The Cask, generally one an unreliable stun. I mean, it can be the best stun in the game if it chains up correctly, but oh no, the Ember's been caught. He just jumps out. Scythe used on to the Shadow Demon. He just drops. The Shadow Demon was the safety blanket of the Ember. Oh, Ember Spirit is getting low. He still has the Aegis. How much longer, though? Doesn't can't be that too much longer. Not really. Shadowfiend does get a kill on the Enchantress as well. The problem I have is that this Enchantress hasn't done anything this game. Like, 172 took part in 3 out of the total 27 kills on her side. If that was something like a. What's another jungler could do somewhat well? I'd even go as far as to say an Axe. I'm not going to completely disrespect the hero by saying something like a Bloodseeker jungle, you know, but a 172, she comes into fight, she gets completely blown up. I think the intention was for her to get a lot of ganks in the laning stage, snowball a bit earlier, be able to blow people up, so. I don't know, I'm just not really feeling the Enchantress pick. I think it's. I mean, look at the level as well. I mean, even the Shadow Demon who got picked off loads by Naga is just beating her in levels now. If this was something like a. Oof, what could have been good? Maybe even just to help out in the lane. You know, something which was, could have semi-carried would have been nice. Even Avenge. I don't know if it was banned now. But Avenge would have been lovely for the Ember Spirit. Extra bonus damage on Cleave, like Ember Spirit's best friend. I can't help but think this is going to get a bit tricky for Pain, though, because this split push is not going to stop. And Nature's Prophet could pop his ult as much as he wants, but you've got a Meepo. You've got a Meepo and you've got a Naga pushing out. The Brute here, he finds the Witch Doctor. Oh no, is he going to be able to get the split off? They're not going to do enough damage in time. He's safe. Split. Okay, so the split is. The Witch Doctor ult is pretty much immediately stopped. The Enchantress dies again in a second. The Tusk's going to drop to the Brew split as well, and the Ember Spirit. The Naga song comes out. They're just trying to wait out the Brew. In the meanwhile, Prophet dies in back lane as well. They're going to disengage. Oh, but the Brew actually does manage to catch up to the Naga. The Sun comes out just the last second. Is that an abyssal on the brew? That is an abyssal on the brew. My god, that brew is hitting really hard all of a sudden. Misses that butterfly. And Narg's just gonna TP out. That Shadow Fiend's like, oh my god, I don't wanna do this anymore. That cleave! Oh my god. Just. I've never seen red bars go white that quickly. Like, what the hell? Just. Wow. I mean, let's look at that fight. I mean. More was lost, obviously. That team fight went on for quite a while. Didn't want to bring up the graph halfway through, but I'd say a very even team fight overall. I mean, you do lose 2 on this side, you lose 4 on that side, but I mean, and Pain Gaming, unless you're going to get something off of this, I don't think it was a purely good exchange. Ember Spirit's now like, you know what? I knew I got. If I had that, if I didn't get evaded, that would have killed that Naga then. I know it would have. So he's like, I'm going for that MKB now. No more evasion, Naga. Your item is now useless. And I just got an item which gives me an extra 88 damage. So I'm happy about that. But just. This is an Ember Spirit in its prime. This is the type of game that all Ember Spirits want to have. What's this KDA as well? I really want to see what he's. 15-111, so he's been notoriously tricky to track down. This is like a really fed Weaver kind of stats. Like, you know, a Weaver gets like a 13-minute Lincolns and then just proceeds to snowball, kill people left, right, and center and never get caught out. And this is exactly what it's like. And the Shadow Fiend just hasn't been felt in these. I mean, he's got his scythe, he's got BKB, his right click's hard, but he's quite limited range, or he's got 500, so not like the pure long range. And the Ember, he can't get to the Ember Spirit, he's jumping around in the fight and he's zipping around. You can get to Enchantress, which seems to be only the person he's targeting on. Tusta's actually meant to get a kill on the Shadow Demon. Is that the gem? That's a gem. I don't know if they picked up that gen earlier one from the Dire team, but. And that's a big trade over just by itself. I mean, look at that. 1,000 gold traded just like that. Who won that ward? Sigil, Nets, anything to get vision. But, I mean, this makes for a very entertaining game. I mean, I love seeing this, like, one big powerhouse. It's like seeing a really fed AM or something like that. Here comes the Ember. Chop, 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 chop. Not that much damage. So he doesn't do that much against the Naga when he doesn't get that crit. But she does have 29 armor. So agility from that, agility from that, agility from that. HP. Meh. You always get to a point where you think, on a Radiance hero, do I sell the Radiance at some point? I mean, for the Naga, it's a part of her essential split push, and Naga's normally one of those heroes that doesn't. Oh no, Enchantress. Here comes. Where are they? Boom, 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 boom. Gone. This Enchantress playing a little bit dangerous. I mean, they know they have the gem, they've been dewarded, and she's still up here by herself with nobody around. So. The Shadow Demon, you can't blame a Shadow Demon for dying this much. I mean, he needs to be close up in these fights, he needs to get these disruptions and these purges. The Enchantress, though, like I said, just look at the difference in the KDA. Like, he's nearly got 6 times more. And that's a. Okay, I wouldn't say it's directly the Enchantress's fault all the time, but I think it was a bit of a strange pick. Especially for, I think it was a third pick. And, you know, we did talk about sort of the weaknesses of this hero at the start, so. You know, just the jungle creatures don't really seem to be that effective anymore when it comes to all these heroes that can just blow them up in a couple of seconds. And Midas, especially since people still tend to go a lot of Midases, like. Nature's Prophet here. Just to stop the creeps, but I don't think anyone on the Dire team did. No. Let's look at the items. I'm going to pull up the items, actually, because I think there's a lot to go over. I mean, the Dire team have, like, a lot of big items. I mean, Tusk is easy to support. You've got Blink and Forest Staff, but Shadow Fiend, MKB, Scythe, BKB, Mech, Naga, 6-slotted. Don't think she can upgrade the Diffusal to level 2. Maybe sell the Radiance late game, but I think she's pretty much capped as it is. Meepo, Scythe, Aghanim's, Forest, Blink. And then on sort of on Pain side, I mean, Brewmaster, I mean, yeah, the Abyssal, that's amazing, you know. He can actually be a right-click Force to be reckoned with now. And Ember Spirit's got a lot, but apart from that, the other three don't really have that much. H Prophet has a Scythe and a Shadow Blade, I guess, but it's one of these games I think is going to be decided by one big team fight. Like, if you catch the Ember out, then Wheel are probably going to go just rush the base, get Roshan, rush the base. They could probably actually get Roshan and then the base, but they're going to go for the Roshan instead now. But then again, they might be able to find who's that. That's the Naga in there. If they can get this off, this will be a big pick. She's going to pop the song. Is there anybody going to come and react? No, she's just baiting out time for the Roshan to drop. Enchantress is like, I'll have one of your illusions. One on one, me noob. Yeah, one on one. Oh wait, one on two. That's not fair. Ah, that Naga can Riptide though. That's the big deal. Oh, they're chasing after each other. Obvious tactical pause because, guys, what do we do about these TP scrolls? These trees are gonna get them. Oh, what are we gonna do with these TP scrolls? Meepo, pick it up. You got room, ain't you? Wait, 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 wait. Where are you? Okay. Oh, no room. Four staff. I guess that's to try and get the highest, or try and get the Meepo out of there if they get binded, maybe. Need a lot of four staff to get all five of them out. Bind only affects two, but. Yep, tree. Go on. Deny. 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 That's effective gold that you could be destroying. That's a shame. I would have liked that. I think she needs a BKB, this Enchantress. Just needs to stop getting hexed and blown up by this magic damage. But then again, there's a right click as well, so. Oh, Ember's here. Ember's flaming. Oh, they're gonna go on the Shadowfiend if they can kill him before the big. Oh, the cheese gets popped out as well. They're gonna still go on him. They don't care. He's gone. Whoa, where did Tusk go? Where did Tusk go? Just get out. Just get out. That's the plan. Look, we gotta get out, guys. Panda claps the floor. He's a happy dab. That Pain got to be very happy with that engagement. You force out a buyback from the Shadowfiend and the Tusk. You don't use the Brewmaster split. And you get out scot-free. And this Abyssal Blade, just. This is. Never used to see it before. Oh, wait, wait, wait. This fight isn't over yet. The tree block. Not quite a block, though. The split comes out. This could be the reinitiation where they wanted. Where is that Ember Spirit? Ember Spirit's actually being held up at top. He can't move anywhere. He's going to go on the Meepo. But I think his team needs him. I don't think his team have the ability to really. No, there's not really much damage being taken all round. They need Ember. Where is he? Here he comes. Here comes Ember. Witch Doctor drops. This could be a dieback for the Shadow Fiend. If he drops down, this could be a big deal. 108 seconds on the side, but Naga as well. Abyssal. I think we had to get her off before the song. The bash. The demonic purge. The purge. No. Shadow Fiend, your destiny has been fulfilled. Highlight of the match right there for this guy. That purge. Well done. Buyback force out from the Naga. They don't have the split. But then again, we all don't have the Aegis of the Cheese. They're going to reinitiate. They're going to try and go to Sen, but they just can't do it. The Tusk is gone. They're going to try and go on the Naga. If this is a dieback from the Naga now, this could be over. The Naga's still there. They might be able to get a kill on the Brewmaster. The Brewmaster's not going to get the Shadow Demon. It's going to go down. Brewmaster might go down shortly afterwards. Brewmaster, he's just running around. He's got evasion. He's sort of making his mind up about who to focus, but he can't make his mind up. Buyback galore. Brewmaster does die to the tower right click. But this Ember Spirit, he's just carving them up in a fight. And I mean, it's a bad sign when your Ember Spirit, the enemy Ember Spirit's all the way up here, all of your team are here, and they can't kill off the rest of the supports. That Shadow Demon lived a long time. You could have a Blink Dagger if you wanted. Buyback from the Shadow Demons. They just want to. Pain just want to throw everything they can at this base now. They might be able to catch the Ember. No, they won't. That's just insane. The problem with Meepo against Ember is that Ember has a chance to crit on every single one of his attacks. As you saw there, a lot of damage, a lot of damage, a lot of damage. Oh, that's a crit. Goodbye, Meepo. You're dead. Let it not be known that Ember Spirit can count, like cannot counter Meepo. You know, I mean, that's a fantastic pick against him. Never thought about that before, but. Every time this Meepo goes in this Ember turns around, Sleight of Fist, and Meepo's dead. Every single time. The Meepo pick may be not as aggressive as I was expecting, but I mean, hands off to. I think the Ember Spirit's played very well. I think all of Pain has, actually. I think they were looking at the draft, you sort of thought we'll have got like the evidently better late game, but they played very well. Pain's Ember Spirit has obviously been backed up by the Shadow Demon, the rest of his team quite nicely. The fight is sort of breaking out all over the place. So we're going to have Shadow Fiend up at top to the Ember Spirit. The rest of them drop down bottom. There's only the poor little Witch Doctor left who can't even finish his Zaganim Scepter. They're going to go for the middle tower and a GG is called. So. What a game. Like, just. The power of this hero. Just. Did I equals win? So. You know. power of that Ember Spirit. You know, he isn't a conventional carry in the way, but I mean, if you don't get your team to get some decent ways to deal with him, I mean, they tried. They got two Scythes of Ice, and it's just they never got a second kill. Oh, they did get a second color. My bad. I think he must have bought back at some point, but 816 GPM, 629 XP per minute, and just they did try. They got a Scythe of Ice on the Meepo. They got a Scythe of Ice on the Shadow Fiend. I don't think he really wanted to go for that, but he's forced into it. Despite the blink daggers, the scythes, the nets, the witch doctor cask, you know, they just could not bring him down. So, I think I talked non-stop for about 15 minutes there, which was kind of shocking. But anyway, guys, this has been the Join Dota League Season 4. This was Wheel versus Pain. The series, or the two-game series, does end on 1-1. So, Wheel did take the first game. Pain Gaming do take the second game. It is now 3:06, and I have got to work this morning. Not tomorrow morning, this morning, which means that I've got to be up in about 5 hours' time. So I'm going to bid you adieu. It has been really fun coming back onto cast for the first time again today. This is the big celebration because this is the first time I've actually been able to get this is an official cast. So this is with Join Dota's permission. They're more than happy for me to do this, which was fantastic. I really thankful for the opportunity. I hope it certainly goes places. You're going to be seeing a bit more of me around. I've volunteered for some small amateur leagues as well as some small British leagues as well. I'm trying to get involved at Insomnia Gaming Festival, which I certainly hope would happen. Just got to have a chat with those guys there to see if we can get anything done. But this is my first time back. I am a bit rusty, so things like an overlay, competitions, handouts, artwork, custom designs, me just not ripping off Omni Knight. That's all going to happen very shortly. I'm very enthusiastic about doing this once again, so I do want to thank all of you for tuning in. And I certainly hope I can see more of you in the future. If you did like what you saw today, you can just click on that follow button at the bottom. I'm not the type of person who expects donations. I'm investing my own money into making the stream as top quality as I can, best equipment, best internet speed. So basically, I just want to make sure I can provide the best show I can to you guys. And I always think we can use more British casters in the scene. Anyway, though, guys, my name is Flower Paladin. I don't know if there's going to be any streams tomorrow. If there is any Join Dota League games tomorrow, I'll be more than happy to cast them. I am free tomorrow evening. I'll jump onto any games that are available, and I hope to see you around as well. So you can follow me on here. If you follow this the stream to the bottom, there will be. There is a link for my Steam ID, and you can also join the Facebook or Twitter, and you can also join the Flower Paladin streaming Steam group as well. Just type in Flower Paladin, it'll come up with me, and it'll come up my group as well. Anyway, guys, this has been Flower Paladin. Thank you very much for tuning in. It has been a pleasure, and I will hopefully see you tomorrow where we can cast some more excellent Dota. And if today's matches were anything to go by, I think that even though this is just, even though it is the Join Dota League, it's not TI4. Absolutely cracking matches, and I'm looking forward to doing the rest of them. So, guys, I bid you good night. Take care, have a wonderful evening, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye bye.